when we talk about structural transformation, we have the standard pattern whereby resources are leaving the low productive agriculture to move into manufacturing, and then as manufacturing plateaus, resources move to the service sector. This is a standard pattern, but you have the African pattern. The pattern you observe in most African countries is that you see resources moving from low productivity agriculture to low productivity service sector, mainly in urban areas. And most of these resources are absorbed by low productive informal sector. So the connection is quite important between this pattern of structural transformation and the informal sector. The explanations we have given to that is both supply and demand sides are in play to explain this. On supply side, you have these demographic trends and these labor migration, which are explained by several factors, especially very low level of public services in rural areas in most African countries. And on the other hand, you have the demand side factors. The business environment in most African countries, especially Francophone African countries, is very, very, very weak. Factor costs are very high. And either activities are taking place in rent-related sectors or in the informal sector. The reasons why manufacturing is struggling to take off in Africa are numerous. Labor costs for the formal sector are very high. Labor regulations are very stringent. This is a very important factor. You have a lot of distortions in the economy, in tax policies, in the customs regimes, in contract enforcement mechanisms. You have challenges at the infrastructural level. You have problems with the financial sector. So all these are compounding the difficulties firms face, in particular in the manufacturing sector, to grow and to thrive. The low productivity informal service sectors, which are far less intensive in all these factors, so are just taking over. And you cannot build a strong development strategy based on that. The rate at which the formal sector is absorbing the high level of increase in demographic flows over the population, but mainly labor force, this rate is very, very, very low. It means that the bulk of employment is generated by the informal sector. And the informal sector usually offers very precarious types of employment. And most of people who are occupied in this sector are underemployed, most of them. If I take, for example, the case of Senegal, the working age population is as big as 9 million of people. Out of these, you barely have 500,000 people who are formally employed. The remainder are in the informal sector. It means that they have no written contract, no benefit, no social benefit, very precarious conditions, and most of them are underemployed. So this is an outcome, a very serious outcome, of the huge discrepancy you observe between the supply and the demand of labor in this part of the world.